Hi students, today I am discussing about the topic is genetics. Unit name is genetics and the topic name is test cross. Four marks important question. Define and design a test cross. The 4 marks question. Test cross means when the heterozygous F1 individual is crossed with a homozygous recessive parent is called as test cross. When heterozygous F1 individual, always the F1 individual is heterozygous in condition. That means it consists of two different alleles present in a single gene is called heterozygous condition. When the heterozygous F1 individual is crossed with a homozygous recessive parent, homozygous means a gene having similar alleles is called homozygous. Recessive parent means the character which cannot express it in the F1 generation. Hence, the character is called recessive character. Homozygous recessive parent is called as test cross. This is the definition of test cross. When the heterozygous F1 individual is crossed with a homozygous recessive parent is called test cross. And the uses of test cross, it is used to determine whether an individual is homozygous or heterozygous. This is the uses of test cross. It is used to determine whether an individual is homozygous condition or heterozygous condition. Example: F1 individual is crossed with a recessive parent. Always the F1 individual is heterozygous in condition. That means it consists of two different alleles. Next, recessive parent means homozygous recessive parent means tall plant, dwarf plant. Then these are the parents, capital T small t and small t small t. It is a heterozygous F1 individual and it is the recessive parent. Always the heterozygous parent produces two gametes and a homozygous parent produces only one gamete, that is small t gamete. These are the gametes. These gametes are fused. A capital T gamete fuses with small t gamete and produces a capital T small t. That means heterozygous tall plant. Heterozygous tall. The tallest character can be expressed with capital T and the dwarf character is expressed with small t small t. Small t gamete fuses with small t gamete and produces a small t plant. It is homozygous. Homozygous dwarf plant. Small t gamete from one parent and capital T and small t gametes from another parent. A capital T gamete fuses with small t gamete and produces a capital T small t heterozygous stall plan. Heterozygous stall and small t gamete fuses with small t gamete and produces a homozygous dwarf. Both the phenotypic ratio and the genotypic ratio. Phenotypic ratio is 1:1. One plant expresses tallness character and another plant expresses dwarf character. Hence, the phenotypic ratio is 1:1 and also the genotypic ratio. Genotypic ratio is also 1:1. This is the test cross. Define and design a test cross. And now next topic is back cross. Back cross means when the F1 individual is always heterozygous in condition. When the F1 individual is crossed with a homozygous dominant parent, is called back cross. For example, F1 crossed with dominant parent. F1, it consists of two different alleles, and the dominant parent means capital T. These are the two parents. One is heterozygous tall parent and another one is homozygous tall parent. And heterozygous tall parent produces two different gametes. They are capital T gamete and small t gamete. And a capital T homozygous parent produces only one gamete, that is capital T. These are the gametes. A capital T gamete fuses with another capital T gamete and produces a capital T plant, that is homozygous tall plant. And another, a small t gamete fuses with capital T gamete and produces a capital T small t plant. It expresses heterozygous tallness character. Heterozygous tall. Hence, the phenotypic ratio is 2:0. Two plants expresses the tallness character. Hence, phenotypic ratio is 2:0 and the genotypic ratio is 1:1. One plant is homozygous tall and another plant is heterozygous tall. This is the back cross. When the F1 individual is crossed with a homozygous dominant parent is called back cross. F1 individual crossed with dominant parent. F1 individual, it consists of two different alleles. Hence, always the F1 individual is heterozygous in condition and a dominant parent is homozygous in condition. And F1 individual produces two different gametes. They are capital T gamete and small t gamete. And capital T plant produces only one gamete, that is capital T gamete. Capital T gamete fuses with capital T gamete and produces a homozygous tall plant. And small t gamete fuses with capital T gamete and produces a capital T small t heterozygous tall plant. Hence, the phenotypic ratio is 2:0. And the genotypic ratio is 1:1. By using of Punnett square, capital capital T gamete fuses with capital T gamete and produces a homogeneous alkyne. Capital T gamete fuses with small t gamete and produces a heterogeneous alkyne. This is the back cross. And now I am discussing about the topic is law of dominance. Law of dominance says that the characters are controlled by discrete units called factors. Characters are controlled by discrete units called factors. Now factors are called as genes. Next, factors generally occurs in pairs. Factors occurs in pairs. In a dissimilar pair, one pair dominates the other. The dominant character and another one is recessive character. This is the law of dominance, and in based on the law of dominance, only one parental character, only one parental character is expressed in F1, and both parental character expressed in the F2 generation. And he also explains the 3:1 ratio obtained. This is the law of dominance. Based on the law of dominance, the characters are controlled by discrete units called factors. Now factors are called as genes. Generally factors occurs in pairs. In a dissimilar pair, one pair of trait dominates the other, and only one parental character is expressed in the F1 generation, and both the parental character is expressed in the F2 generation. And also the ratio, phenotypic ratio 3:1 is obtained. This is the law of dominance. Next, another topic, law of segregation or law of purity of gametes. The law of segregation is based on the results of monohybrid cross, Mendel's monohybrid cross. It is based on the results of Mendel's monohybrid cross. And it explains that when the F1 individual have two different alleles, these two alleles they did not or do not blend or fuse each other. These two alleles, they did not blend or fuse each other, but the formation of gametes are during the meiosis. Both the gametes are independently segregated, hence it is called as law of segregation, or it is also called as law of purity of gametes. It states that, and it is based on the results of Mendel's monohybrid cross, and always the F1 individual having two different alleles, these two alleles they did not or they do not blend or fuse each other, but the formation of gametes are during the meiosis process, both the gametes are independently segregated. Hence, this law is called as law of segregation, or it is also called as law of purity of gametes.